Has told Caroline B. Maloney, a member of the U.S. Congress, that Rwandan justice system is independent and terror suspect Paul Rusesabagina's arrest was based on key facts that not only are in the public domain, but that he has not disputed. Diana Iriza, our correspondent in Rwanda, has more details.
The response comes after the Congresswoman Caroline Maloney sent a letter addressed to President Paul Kagame on 14th December requesting for the release and return to the United States of Rusesabagina. In his letter, December 16th, the Minister of Justice and also Attorney General Johnson Businje reminded Maloney that the Rwanda Investigation Bureau and the National Public Prosecution Authority have in the past clarified in court and to the media that Rusesabagina was not kidnapped or extradited. He departed Dubai voluntarily by private jet, and when his plane landed in Rwanda and he voluntarily alighted, he was placed under arrest pursuant to a 2018 NPPA arrest warrant. Businje told the Congresswoman that Rusesabagina is not the only suspect. He reminded that Rusesabagina is alongside 18 others who were charged by NPPA with 9 serious charges, including formation of an irregular armed group, membership of a terrorist group, financing terrorism, murder, abduction, armed robbery, attempted murder, and assault and robbery, all as acts of terrorism. Rusesabagina has himself on multiple times admitted to funding and fundraising for FNL-MRCD, a militia outfit that made incursion into Rwanda at different times, killing people among other atrocities. Paul Rusesabagina, alongside 18 other terror crime suspects, will be tried at the High Court Chamber for International and Cross-Border Crimes. The trials will begin on the 26th of January, 2021. Diana Iriza, Kigali, Rwanda.